Using procedural approach, we can create also the assets. In this sense, I mean, instead of modeling some particular model, we can create a rule which will define all possible models that type. For example, instead of creating of let's say building skyscraper, we can create an asset where we can control the amount of floors, the shape and amount of windows by parameters. And that makes the possibility to randomize these assets, to create a huge array of geometries very easy, and you can easily generate random versions or correct your models. And basically you save a lot of time creating some repeatable work. So I want to show the very basic example, like quite typical example, how to create something like procedural gear. So let me start another model. I can create a tube. Then I apply a poly extrude here. Then I have a basics for this gear. And now, for example, we want to select every second of frontal polygons to make a teeth of this gear. And what is very, very cool in Houdini, and particularly in TouchDesigner 2, that we can do a procedural selection. That is actually a basis for procedural modeling. For example, this poly extrude, this is a smart operator because it's anyway a function creating this shape. It knows about the frontal polygons itself. And that way we can save this information for the future usage. So if I just click this flag front group, then inside of geometrical flow, inside of data contained by this geometry, Houdini will know that we have 12 polygons which are on front of this extrusion. Then I can create another rule called group by range, and even I can make something like split. So I will split the geometry on two flows by that extrude front group. So we will have only this frontal geometry here. And I apply the second rule where I want to select every second polygon. So I select one polygon of two polygons. And now I selected every second polygon. And I can use that information to make a second poly extrusion. And now I just say that I only poly extrude the group one polygons, and then I make the teeth with some inset. Then I can merge the results together. Then I can fuse points to make it complete geometry, not containing from two pieces. And then I even can apply a small poly bevel to make the geometry looking nicer. And here I can say I don't want to produce bevel on the flat geometries. So now I have that nice smoothed geometry. Then I can create the and here I can say I want to cast polygons to make it flat. And that is basically is. We just defined a very simple rules. So we have a tube. Only important thing that this tube should have always even amount of columns, because we want to select every second polygon. Then we poly extrude. This poly extrude produce the group which is extrude front. Then using split on first output, it will be this extrude front group. On the second, it put everything else. Then here we use a group range to select primitives, and when we select one primitive of two primitives, so every second primitive. and then we extrude. And now we can even, in order to make that reusable, we can add some parameters to it. Let me show very simple workflow. I can create a null operator which doesn't do anything. It's just operator, don't producing new data. Then we can call it control. We can even change the shape and color. And now we can create a custom parameter interface. Then I can create an integer parameter because we cannot create 1.5 TIFF. So the parameter should be integer. And we call this parameter num, and label we will be number of TIFFs. So now I can also define that I want to have at least 5 TIFFs. So I can define the range from 5 until 10, for example, and accept. So now I copy this parameter, go to the original tube and paste relative reference and multiply it by 2. So now I can control the amount of TIFFs by the parameter, which is actually a very good example how we can make a controllable asset. And I will not stop too much on that, but we can save that as a digital asset, which will be available in our assets menu. So in this operator create dialog, I can create my own custom gear, which has some different parameters. And we can control a bunch of stuff using these parameters. So then if we want to create more of these gears, we just apply this operation a lot of times, and then we can reuse that. Now we created 2 gears with different settings. I don't want now to spend 2 hours showing all possible techniques in Houdini. My reason was just to bring you some small understanding what is the main profits of using procedural pipeline and how easy is that actually, and how profitable is that for the production. And then we can load that geometries to TouchDesigner to render it in real time. Also very cool that we use Houdini and TouchDesigner. Why Houdini in this sense is better to use with TouchDesigner in comparison to, let's say, Cinema 4D. The reason is that all this geometrical data contains not only points and polygons, it also can contain some additional metadata. For example, these primitive groups. These primitive groups are information about that selected primitives. We can also have different colors or different additional data attached to primitives or points, which is called on Houdini and TouchDesigner slang as a geometrical attributes. And if we use Houdini and TouchDesigner together, we can access these attributes also in TouchDesigner. That's mean if I go now and will save the geometry, rob geometry output, I can use a common format which can understand both TouchDesigner and Houdini. So I will save that project gear, and then I can export here to BH Classic, which is common data, geometrical data format between Houdini and TouchDesigner. So now I can go back to TouchDesigner, and now I can load that geometry using file in SOP. So you can see this gear inside of TouchDesigner. And for example, I want to apply different materials to the frontal group and this other part. So I still have this information, group 1 and extrude front. So that means I can delete here the group front primitives. Maybe makes sense to turn back to Houdini and add here the additional groups, so I can say, okay, I will make a new group, call that thieves. So now I re-export that geometry again, then I turn back to TouchDesigner, refresh the model, and now I have the additional thieves group, so I can use thieves group to delete that part, and then I can use delete non-selected, so to have that part separately. And then, for example, I will pack that to two geometrical objects. For example, I can create a camera. I can put null to make it look at so that camera. So I can look to my gear from a bit from top. Then I will create a light and render. So now I just rendering it using very basic shaders, so it's not super photorealistic. But what I wanted, why I wanted to make that, that now I can, for example, use the additional material for that thieves, and then, for example, I can make the animation of transparency of these thieves. For example, I will create a noise with random, and then I will drop it to the alpha front parameter. So I can create something crazy on TouchDesigner side without to be needed to go back to Houdini to change something. That is very cool because we have additional information about these groups, which can only be exported from Houdini. Because of that, even if I, for some, let's say, commercial project, I will receive some 3D data from other program, doesn't matter from any, I will load it first to Houdini to pre-process that geometry and prepare for TouchDesigner to be more efficiently, to make the workflow more efficient, always. Because TouchDesigner and Houdini supports the same data format.